Further ado, right now, I want to bring in the chairman of the World Wrestling Federation, Vince McMahon.
Hey,
he is on the hot seat, ready to take your calls and questions. Good morning, Vince.
Good morning.
I got to say, in case you didn't know, any Big Venom's here.
Mr. McMahon, you know, Mr. McMahon, 3 years. I've been writing for this rag of a magazine right here. And you know what, Mr. McMahon? For 3 years, people have been writing to Vic Venom, Vic, when are they going to put you on television? You're the only one who tells it like it is in the World Wrestling Federation. When are you going to be on television? And you know what, Mr. McMahon? For 3 years, I wasn't put on television for two reasons. You want to know what they are?
Sound like Jim Ross. Go ahead.
For two reasons. Number one, because you are sitting up there in your ivory tower with all your cronies up there, afraid of what Vic Venom might say on television, afraid that Vic Venom might say the truth. As a matter of fact, maybe you were pulling eggs out of your butt, afraid of Vic Venom. And reason number two, Mr. McMahon, let me say reason number two is I think personally that you are prejudiced, Mr. McMahon. You know why? Because I'm from New York, and I know that you have a problem with New Yorkers because I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth like some people around here. But you know what? This isn't about me, and that was then, and this is now, and I'm not going to cry over some still Budweiser or something.
I thought you had a question.
I do have a question.
Well, you do it.
Mr. McMahon, let me ask you. You are the guru of professional wrestling, am I correct? And before you, it was your father, and before him, it was Grandpa Jeff, correct? Now, with all this knowledge and all this experience, I have one question and one question only for you, and so does everybody else out there. How can this show be so awful, Mr. McMahon? Look at the production facilities. Look at the people you have working on this set. How can this show be so awful?
I didn't think it was.
It is, Mr. McMahon. You're fooling the people. You're not being honest with them. We have Michael P.S. Hayes here making believe he's Doc Hendricks, a walking billboard. We're not being honest with the fans of the World Wrestling Federation. I have a problem with that.
Well, first of all, let's get a couple things straight. It is the World Wrestling Federation, and it is an opportunity. This is Livewire, and everything we do is for the fans. JR had an opportunity on live television to get some things off his chest. We're going to address that today, all right? He got those things off his chest. Indeed, it's an open forum. Anything can happen here in the World Wrestling Federation. And likewise, this is an open forum. You took advantage of the same thing Jim Ross took advantage of, right? You know we're live. You know you have access to everything here in the studio. You came on and you're here. So therefore, your question is, what's wrong with the show? I don't think there's anything wrong with the show.
Come on.
You know, let's not get wrong.
Don't say it again.
Excuse me, people at home, again, this is typical wrestling. Wrestling isn't wrestling. Well, what do you say down there in Kentucky or Tennessee, wherever you come from? Typical wrestling, Jim Cornette.
Don't
this is 1996, Jim Cornette. You hear me? People don't want to hear this anymore. Okay?
Now, what's the temperature?
I'm not concerned about that. I'm concerned about
you
the fans. I seem to be the only one here who's concerned about the fans.
I'd like to talk with our fans, Doc.
I would like to talk to the fans. I know they want to
talk.
That's
what's important.
I got a real quick question for you. Did it bother you personally? Did it hurt you, what Jim Ross said 2 weeks ago on Raw?
Sure it did.
I mean, I would imagine that it would.
JR has been, if he's not now, still disgruntled. And he is distorting the facts. Jim Ross, as a matter of fact, was not fired. Jim Ross, he was only fired on one occasion for sufficient reason. But JR's contract expired. I elected not to pick up his contract. Unfortunately, he contracted Bell's palsy at about the same time.
What was the reason he got fired then?
Well, that's the second time. Again, the first time he claims he was fired, he really wasn't. It was just his contract expired. And from there, the second reason he got fired because he was talking to the wrong people.
Uh-huh.
Giving away trade secrets, things of that nature,
right,
from an inside standpoint.
Who did he talk to? Can you name them specifically? I mean, was it these stupid sheet writers? And that's my opinion, and I'll say it again,
for
stupid
one,
sheet writers.
For one, yeah. But I think JR, you know, wanted to talk to anyone. I mean, JR had a problem, I think, in terms of credibility. And JR likes to have his back patted a bit, as we all do, but JR maybe more than others. And JR took advantage of this live forum to get a lot of things off his chest. Cool. That's great. And he is a very good broadcaster. Therefore, if he doesn't get too far out of line, it's all right.
Is he a better broadcaster than you?
I don't know.
Is he better on play-by-play?
I don't know. Maybe he is. I don't know. It doesn't matter. Does it really?
The people of the World Wrestling Federation, it is a competitive nature. Do you think he's a better play-by-play man than you?
I don't know. It doesn't matter.
Well, you know, again, that his loose lips were sinking ships, and why'd you hire him back to begin with?
We give a lot of people second chances here in the World Wrestling Federation, and you should know that. Okay.
All right, I'll tell you what.
A lot of people second chances.
Oh, no. This is... This is for the people. We're taking calls. We're taking faxes. So right now we're going to go to Mike from Florida. Let's see. Mike, are you there?
Yeah.
All right. What's up, Mike? Good morning.
I wanted to know what you think about the Razor Ramon and Diesel incident.
Is this question for Vince?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't know whether or not JR was trying to embarrass the World Wrestling Federation or exactly what he was trying to do. I think it's a somewhat of a novel idea that JR would bring back this guy who looks quite a bit like Razor Ramon and quite a bit like Diesel. The question is whether or not they can wrestle. And that's the bottom line. No matter whether you call him Razor, Diesel, whomever, the bottom line is whether or not they can perform in the ring. And time will tell.
I'd say so far they look like they're ready pretty good.
And time will tell.
Okay.
Excuse me for a second. I have an email from Vince. It's from Master of the WWF. He says, Vince, what is going on with this whole ECW thing? Do you think that the ECW is trying to take over the WWF? Like the NWO is trying to take over the WCW.
No. This is simply, again, just like Mr. Venom, and I might add, I'm a fan of your writing. I think you're a gifted writer, all right? No, I really do.
Okay.
A very prejudicial point of view, but nonetheless, it's welcome. The fact that you came on Livewire today because it was live, interjected yourself. JR said what he said because it was live. The same with ECW in Philadelphia.
Right.
ECW is a local wrestling organization for the benefit of those you don't know out of Philadelphia. So they took advantage. We're right there in their hometown within your house, okay?
Well.
So they came out and interjected themselves, and then furthering that, on the live show, we tried to stay off of it as much as we possibly could on Raw, but none of us who picked up some of it. They want to make a name for themselves at the expense of the World Wrestling Federation. It is all about ego.
Okay.
Same for Jim Ross. It's all about ego.
Anyway, let's talk about ego, Vince McMahon, because you yourself said that Jim Ross is an excellent commentator, but you did a nice little tap dance around the question Doc asked you. My question is, if he is such a good commentator, then why was he put on the bench second string behind the almighty Vince McMahon? Answer that question and don't give me a tap dance.
I'm not going to give you a tap dance. Who does WWF Superstars? Who tomorrow is going to be on the air?
Show. You know that's not the main show for the WWF. It's WWF Raw. That's the main show, and you know that. Prime time, 9 o'clock Monday night.
All right.
Why were you first string?
The main reason we're here today is for the fans.
Privileges I look around here somewhere.
We're going to take a call from the fans. That's the main reason we're here. All right. Bruce from Connecticut, you're on.
Hey, Bruce.
Mr.
Bruce.
McMahon.
Yes, right, Bruce.
I happen to agree with you that the E for ECW should have the word ego involved, because isn't it your ego, sir, that the WWF continues to steal concepts, ideas, and talent from ECW giving them the proper credit?
I know who this is.
Isn't it true, Mr. McMahon, that it's your ego, that you're the one that wants to take the credit for the hardcore style of ECW?
Isn't it true that you're not Bruce?
Shut up! You're interrupting while I'm talking! You think the NWO is extreme? You think Eric Bischoff's hairstyle is extreme? Why don't you invite your viewers to check out ECW? What the hell do you have to be afraid of?
Nothing, and if you had identified yourself correctly as who you truly are, we would have put you on the air. Yes, we would. We would have put you on the air. But instead of that, you come on as Bruce from Connecticut.
Well, who the hell do you want me to be, Vince?
Now, you're Paulie from Philadelphia, and you could use decaf, by the way. I'm listening to it.
Listen, why don't you sit there and shut the F up?
That's enough. Goodbye. Well, there you heard it from JR, Vince. First of all, he says that you hired him back 50 cents on a dollar.
Not true.
Second of all, he alluded to the fact that possibly he is the main catalyst why people have left the World Wrestling Federation, maybe gone down to WCW, or vice versa. There's been a big influx of wrestlers that came from Atlanta to here. How much validity is in that statement, to your knowledge?
I really don't know, Doc. I think time will tell. I don't know if the World Wrestling Federation has necessarily been hurt by the activities of Jim Ross as we continue our investigation. But JR obviously has been very, very busy.
So you're investigating? That's the first time you've said that. You're investigating. What, have you got private eyes on the subject? You got the fans, maybe? I know you know him personally.
Oh, let's not. We've done the federal government stuff, okay? Let's get over that.
Who have you got investigating Jim Ross?
investigating his activities, okay?
Well, who's looking into that? After all, here's
a man who came on and said he has no loyalty to the World Wrestling Federation under normal circumstances. As far as insubordination is concerned, that's enough to fire him right on the spot just because of that.
Okay. All right.
Except for that contract he's got.
Let's take a call. This is the fan show. All right. We've got Tom from Pennsylvania. Tom, are you there? Tom?
Tom.
Hello, Tom.
Hello.
All right. Next call.
Let me just say this before we take our next
caller.
All right. You know, the gentleman who called earlier, you really don't have to hide, who you are. If you have something to say and it's important or a question, even if it's controversial, if possible, we will get you through. We're not trying to... What do you mean?
You mean you'll dance around it if it's controversial, just like you're dancing around. You know, Mr. McMahon...
Excuse me, you have a microphone on, don't you? The producers put a microphone
on
you.
Thank you for the microphone.
So you can say your piece, too.
Maybe you're in the wrong business. Maybe you should have ran for office or something. The answer is that you're giving these fans today. That's the reason why I'm here. I'm a watchdog.
All right, we're taking a call. Brandon from Ohio, are you there?
What about Tom?
Tom, okay, Tom, you're on. It's live. It's you, Tom. Go for it.
My question's to Vince. Vince, why do you think KR is so bitter towards you and so bitter towards the World Wrestling Federation?
I guess maybe we're going to... Time will tell on that again. I think JR feels that, he blames the World Wrestling Federation for a lot of his problems. I mean, let's face it. Here's a man who many would say probably should not be on camera. He has Bell's palsy. I don't know of any other producer that would allow a talent like that to be on the air, except us here in the World Wrestling Federation. He was not fired for that reason at all. Again, his contract expired. Nonetheless, we continue to put him on the air because he's a good broadcaster, and he certainly brings a very fresh point of view to the World Wrestling Federation, no doubt about that.
Let me just jump in here and just show my fans out there what a fair journalist I am. I have to agree with you on this one. Jim Ross does have this Bell's palsy. I mean, he's got one eye up here and one eye down here in Fort Lauderdale. Now, I'm not saying that the man should be put in a bell tower in Notre Dame or something like that, but, to be honest with you, I don't know if I'd put him on TV myself. And let me say something for all you people out there with Bell's palsy. Don't write cards and letters to Vic Venom crying to me because I'm poking fun at Jim Ross because he's got Bell's palsy. Because I really like you people. I mean, you people do tell the truth. You always talk out of one side of your mouth, and I like that.
Let's hear from the fan.
All right. Who are we going to
hit next?
Thank you. We're going to Brandon from Ohio. Brandon, are you there? Brandon?
I guess maybe Vic is chasing everyone away.
I'm in the WWF chat room right here on AOL, and these people are going crazy. We have 47 people in the room right now, and they're all talking about Vince McMahon. First of all, they're saying you're acting very calm in the situation you've been put in right now, but they are... on Vic Venom's side.
Thank you.
They're on Vic Venom's side. What is
Vic Venom's side?
Vic Venom's side is honesty. Vince McMahon, you're coming across smooth. You've been here, done this 100 times. Nobody's buying it. I'm not buying it. Go on with the scam.
I mean, these people just want to know the real truth.
And that's a question, Mr. Jim Ross. Jim, are you there on the line?
I sure am, Doc, and I tell you something. You talk about smasher of egos. You're looking right at him right now. Vince McMahon, Vince, how can you be so vain as to pass judgment on what I look like? And the stress you put me under is the reason I look like this. And I didn't come on to be a movie star anyway. I'm a journalist, something that you know nothing about. That's exactly the truth.
That's why you're on the air now.
Huh?
The reason you're on the air now is because you are somewhat of a journalist.
Somewhat. And you're Edward R. Murrow, I guess. You're Walter.
No, that's not what I'm saying.
You should be retired out on a yacht somewhere or living in your mansion in Greenwich and leave the rest of us to hell alone and let us do our damn job.
I think that's what I'm doing there, JR, as long as you don't cross that line. And, of course, he just hung up.
Well, I guess he didn't want to hear your response there. But I'm kind of interested in it. I mean, I could feel a change in your personality right then.
Mm-hmm.
Personally, this doesn't bother you. You kind of avoided that question earlier.
Anytime there's confrontation, obviously you're going to get a response out of that, and I think JR is out of line.
All right, one thing that I was kind of confused about, you guys are saying he should be off the air because of his look, no matter
how
it came
about. That's not what I said. I said he's on the air in spite of his look. And JR, I'm not trying to make fun of the way you look. Indeed, I'm just saying that you're on the air because you are somewhat of a journalist. You bring a point of view. You do very good play-by-play. That's why you're on the air in spite of Bell's palsy. Name me one other broadcaster anywhere in sport or anywhere in entertainment who has Bell's palsy and is still on the air, only here in the World Wrestling Federation. So I think that speaks pretty highly of the producers here, Kevin Dunn and people who make decisions.
Okay, I'm kind of curious to how solid his contract is, because He says there's only been like one portion of the story revealed, unveiled. Obviously, he's got a lot more in store for you personally and for the World Wrestling Federation as an entity.
And I think that JR can have his forum, just as Vic can have his forum. Again, I think here in the World Wrestling Federation, it's important that we open things up for our fans as much as we possibly can. So JR will have an opportunity to say whatever he's going to say, as long as he didn't go too far with it.
Well, I'm sure he'll do that tomorrow on Superstars and Monday on Raw.